So Christopher just walked you through how to actually train a model. And yes, that can feel a bit anticlimactic. I once was chatting with a data scientist who told me that, you know, 80% of your time is spent actually preparing the data to do the training, and only 20% of your time is actually spent training the model. When it gets down to the code, it's really one line of code that you execute to train your model. You spend most of your time doing that preparation, getting the data ready for training. And it's interesting, you may notice over the next couple of modules, same sort of thing. Really, it's just sort of one line of code does all the magic for us. It's getting the data ready that's going to take you most of your time. But we have got a model trained based on the code that you saw with Christopher. So now let's take a look at how we actually test the model once we trained it, so we know it's actually somewhat accurate and that we can rely on that model and make decisions based on that model. So how do we test a model? When we were looking at Christopher's content, you saw that we had split up our data into four parts. We had X-train and X-test, which was the X-train is the data we used to train our model, along with Y-train. Y-train being the values we're predicting, X-train being our features. And then we also had test data, X-test and Y-test. And that was data we had put aside for testing. And that's what we're going to use to check how accurate our model is. So what we can do is take that X-test data we put aside, and we're going to use that to test our model. So we use predict is the method that we typically use on the different models to say, here are some values that we would like to test with. Please try and predict values for those different values in our test data. So we take the data in X-test, and we pass that in using our regressor, which is the model object we had created, and we call predict. And we pass in the test data, and it will pass back a prediction for each of the rows of test data. And we can put that into a data frame. I'm calling it Y predicted, because that's sort of nice and consistent. We have Y test for the actual values for our test data, and now we have Y prediction containing the predicted values for our test data. So now, once we've finished that, we'll be able to compare the results we have in Y test, which is the actual values that happen for each record, to the predicted values our model gave us for each of the rows of our test data. And by comparing, here we, you know, the first row, the first flight was 5 minutes early. Our model predicted it would be just over 3 minutes late. The second row, it predicted it would be 20 minutes late. Our model predicted it would be about 6 minutes late, and so on. So now we get a sense of whether our model's doing a good job making those predictions. Now let's take a look at this in some actual code.